We can't stop here. This is Demon Country. I'm Duke of the Bump, and this is more or less play like Crusader. In the last episode, we just got the silver key from up there. I'm not 100% sure what the silver key opens, but it's gotta be around here somewhere. It's raining outside now, so hopefully the sound of the rain won't interfere too much with my recording. Hopefully. It seemed to have eased up a little bit since I started fiddling with my settings and stuff, so that's good. I wouldn't want that to be too distracting. Today's choice of music is called The Scourge of 1691, and it's from a free arrangement of Castlevania music for the electric guitar. I've already talked to this guy. So, why wasn't that on my map? Oh, I guess it was. I got turned around somewhere. But yeah, I definitely recommend checking it out. I'll put a link to it over in the information section. Okay, so I want to go north and then east. He has arrangements of music from all of the original NES Castlevania games, which really have some of the best music in video games. I mean, between Mega Man 2 and the Castlevania games, I mean, that's it. You can't get NES music better than that. They're pretty much the only soundtracks that I listen to in their original formats, not arranged or remixed or anything like that. I mean, I do, but I also listen to the original songs. Let's go west instead of... I don't think we've been up here. Or have we? This looks awfully familiar. I never did figure out the secret of these lampposts. I should have looked it up or something before I started doing this. I know there's a secret here, damn it. It can't be that hard. Try leaving just the middle lamp lit. No. Let's try unlighting just the middle lamp. No. This is most perplexing. Oh well. Maybe I'll come back here, maybe I won't. It's been a lazy day. I've just been sitting around on my computer all day. No, you don't get any water. No water for you. I'm just kidding. You can have some water. It's not like I need it. Thank you! The mirror! There's a pathway in the mirror! Oh, don't tell me I had to talk to that guy before I could open up the pathway. I hate forced triggered events like that. Yep, there it is. I guess sometimes events like that are necessary. Come on. Element's full. Oh, isn't that just dandy? Oh crap. These guys are pretty tough. Pretty damn tough. Haha, he hit that guy with his shield. That's funny. Video games are always amusing when one monster attacks another. I wish more games did that. Okay, and that opens up the invisible force field, preventing me from going this way. And we've been in this room before, but now we're up on top. Hey, what's she doing here?
Something dreadful has happened. The princess has been kidnapped by the Wizards Guild. I don't know why I talk like an evil man.
Oh, shit. I shouldn't have touched that goblin. Aw, man. I don't like these. At least they're easier to kill now that I have the Elk Crusader. What are goblins doing all the way down here? Wonder if they'll let me through if I'm wearing my costume. It's worth a shot. No, they won't let me through. But it makes them easier to kill. Do-do-do-do-do. Ah, screw this. I do more damage to them with my sword anyway. So I'll take a few points of damage, big deal. I have food. And honey. And water. Steak, honey, banana, bread. Banana bread. I'm actually not hungry this time. Oh shit, it's a mancubus. A flying mancubus. That's even worse. Okay, there's some sort of strategy involving these lampposts. I think I need to turn them off or something. And when he hits the lamppost with his fire, they light up, which causes something to happen. I'm not sure. I think it's related to that little diamond thing that was floating around him. Lighting the lamppost activates that or something. I don't know. Ow. Oh, come on. This is a pretty ugly monster. Has a flying with those tiny little wings to define the laws of physics. The physics in this game are not nearly realistic enough. I'm not a satisfied consumer. Oh, I remember. When he hits that crystal thing with the fire, it heals him. Because his life just went up. I'm not sure how that's related to the lampposts. I'm sure they have something to do with it. Stop it. Uh-oh. I have 3 hit points left. Steak. Tomato. Tomato. So I need to prevent him from spawning that crystal at all costs. Or something. Okay, it heals him when I hit the crystal too, not just when he hits it, which makes sense. This would be so much easier if he really was a mancubus. All I'd have to do is circle strafe around him. Okay, crystal. Here come the fireballs. Almost got him. Almost. So close and yet so far away. God. Yes! Ow! He's still hurting me. That wasn't fair. And we have some more wizards to take care of. Most annoying enemy in the game. Almost as annoying as Wizrobes. Luckily, I can jump. I haven't really talked about anything in this LP or in this episode, and I apologize for that.
thank you so much for your help. A long time ago... I'm not keeping that up. A long time ago, my mother told me that the man called Bloodroke used to be a friend of my father's, and both asked my mother to marry them, but she chose my father. Roke left the castle and became leader of the Wizards Guild. Ever since, he's been waiting for the chance to take his revenge against my father and this country. To revive the evil demon, they need the lives of sacrificial victims. If we save those victims, the evil demons cannot be revived. Alright, plot. Okay, that about wraps it up for this episode. I'm Duke of the Bump. See you next time.